Hi, welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm making hummus. Hummus is very quick, easy and great for unexpected guests as well. And it is very nutritious as well. You can serve this as a side dish or you can spread in the sandwiches or you can... Usually this hummus is used with the pita bread or chips. You can roast the pita bread or you can fry the pita bread or make the pita chips. And use this hummus as a dip. So however you like, you can use it. So let's start making. I have here the processor I'm using because I want to make this smooth hummus. And in order to make this smooth hummus, the processor is the best. But if you don't have the processor, you can use any kind of blender you have. So here I have the chickpea or garbanzo beans. I soaked overnight and I boiled this morning and it's fresh. So ready to go into the processor. Oh, actually I'm gonna keep some for the top. Alright, so that should be just enough. So this chickpea or garbanzo beans is the key ingredient to make this hummus. Now the second most ingredient is that tahini paste is used for this recipe. Now I don't have tahini. I usually don't stack my pantry with tahini paste. Tahini is basically sesame seeds paste, and what I normally do is I have this sesame seeds soaked into the water. I soaked this morning. It's not necessary to soak, but it really works great when you blend if you have a soaked sesame seeds. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it in the microwave for about 30 seconds. So this is done. I put it in a microwave for about 60 seconds and it has got soft now. So get all the sesame seeds in there. Here I have the 1 clove of garlic. I have 1 1/4 cup of chickpeas, garbanzo beans. For that, I added about 1 1/2 tablespoons of sesame seeds, soaked sesame seeds. Now if you're using tahini, you can use as much as you want or as little as you want. But about 8 to 10 tablespoons of tahini you can add for 1 1/4 cup of garbanzo beans. So that's in there. Now here I have another third ingredient that I'm going to add is the roasted red bell pepper. These days, this is one of my favorite to add in almost many recipes. So I'm going to add this. I need about 1/4 cup of roasted red bell pepper, so I'm just going to eyeball. If it's a little bit more than or less than that, it will be okay for me. So this is just enough. If you don't have the roasted red bell pepper, you can leave it out, and you can make your own fresh homemade roasted red bell pepper as well. Just coat with the olive oil and salt and pepper if you wish, and then roast into the boiler, and you can take out the skin, and that's your roasted red bell pepper. And about 1/4 teaspoon of salt. I'm just going to eyeball here. And here I have the cumin powder. So about 1/4 or a little bit less than 1/4 teaspoon of cumin powder. I like the taste of cumin powder a lot. And now I'm going to put the lid on. And I'm going to blend about 2 minutes, almost 2 minutes. And I want very smooth hummus, so I'm going to add a little bit of water. Okay. Alright, so now it looks very smooth. And if you wish, you can also use the feta cheese in this hummus. Open it. As soon as you open, the aroma is so wonderful here. Can't wait to taste it. I'm going to take out this hummus into the bowl here. Now usually if I would have to do for the guest, what I usually do is I take, if I have the red bell pepper, I use the red bell pepper usually, but I'm just going to show you what I do. I take the red color bell pepper. I don't have it anyway. I have the yellow and the green only. But what I do is I cut the top part and make the bottom flat as well. You can take out the any branch it has, if it has, and you can just put it like that and fill this hummus into this pepper. It looks so inviting and mouth watering. So this is what normally I do, but I just made it for myself today. So I'm just going to take out into the bowl. When I don't have anything to eat or when I prefer to eat healthy food, I choose usually to make something quick, easy, it doesn't have to be for particular. Now this recipe is usually used for pita bread or chips or something, but for me, it's not necessary. I use on a sandwich, I use for any other chips or just as a side. Tastes heavenly delicious. So take out all the hummus. Now normally what I do is just with the spatula, just do like that, and I'll show you the reason why you want to do that. Now on the top, you remember I kept some chickpeas, the garbanzo beans boiled, and here I cut some red bell pepper, the roasted red bell pepper. I'm going to put that on the top. So put one on one side, all the chickpeas like that. And then randomly just put the roasted red bell pepper just like that. The reason I do this on the top, just to give your guests a little visual hint what's in there, so they can just imagine, oh, it's hummus and it's made from with the chickpea and the roasted red bell pepper. And now it's time to give it a bite with the chips. And here I have the nice chips, the fresh. I just open up the pack, dip with the hummus. Tastes heavenly delicious. On the top, you can do one more thing. Paprika. You can sprinkle a little bit of paprika. Just lightly, just like that. And one more thing, the olive oil. You can pour some little bit of olive oil on the top. This enhances the flavor of this hummus a lot. And make sure that you use the one that says great for dipping and pouring, not the cooking. So I always have two kinds of olive oil in my kitchen. One is for the cooking and one is for the dipping. And all right, so this is ready. So this was all about the quick and easy hummus. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon with the next great recipe.